Good morning, everyone.
Good morning, sir. Good morning, sir.
Okay.
Good morning, sir.
Okay, so what I will do is I'll share the PPT here and I'll be changing the slides. So whenever you just let me know, okay, change the slide, I'll change the slide. Okay, I'm just testing it right now. Because this is in the presentation mode. I've never tried this. I usually present the PDFs. So, yeah, okay. I'm just trying to check if I'm able to change the slides quickly. Alright. Got it. So, Supriya, you going first. Just keep your
yes, ma'am. Yes, sir.
Video on and your microphone on while you're yes. presenting. Everyone else, just keep it muted. Both the video as well as mic, and you can start whenever you're ready. Okay, take 20-30 seconds. Keep it to
yes.
10 minutes. Don't really stretch it too far. So yeah, you can go now, Supriya.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. Am I audible?
Yeah, yeah. Completely.
Okay.
Perfectly audible.
Yes, sir. Yes. Yes, sir. So my case study is Mumbai City, and my project is Balaji Park, which is in Kharghar, Navi Mumbai. So here's the location. It is under construction. This is the pic of the plot. Next. So this is the basic project information. The location is Kharghar in Maharashtra. The area of land in meters is 5192, and then it's yards and square feet. TP scheme number, I didn't get it, but the authority is CIDCO. Then zone is pure residential zone, R1. Your residential zone R1 includes the different residential apartments and as well as some of the commercial sectors also and shopping malls, etc. Then the FSI and FAR permissible is 1.3 to 1.5. Total buildup available is 7,782 square meter, then yards and square feet. Total super buildup area is 12,919 square meter and yards and square feet. Market price of the land in meters was 1,09,988 per square meter and 91,980 per square yard and 10,220 per square feet. Next. This is the basic tax payable. Betterment charges, I didn't get it, but the plot or the survey number is plot 6A, which is in sector 17. Gentry value is for open land is 28,000 per square feet. For residential is 37,000 per square feet. And for commercial, it is 45,000 per square feet. This is the approximate values. Stamp duty rate is 6%. In which 4% is the stamp duty, 1% is the local body tax, and 1% is the transportation surcharge. 6% is for the Navi Mumbai area. It varies with the type of area. GST rate on construction is 12%. It is existing, but there is I've seen that it is going to be 5% in future. The check value of the project in meters, square yard and feet. Cash value is this, and the total value of the project is 9,500 per square feet.
Yeah, so in the total value, ideally you should have multiplied that 9,500 with the total square feet of the land area, and that would have got
Okay.
project back. It's all right. No problem.
Okay. Okay, sir. So the project concept is, the project is Balaji Park, which is a residential project of 2 and 3 BHK apartments. There are 96 units, that is two buildings. This project provides a vast range of amenities, including landscaping and tree planting, etc. The existing market price of the project is 12,000 per square feet, but the target price is 9,500 per square feet. Means 12,000 per square feet is the approximate market price range in the Kharghar of the residential projects, but our project is of rupees 9,500 per square feet.
Okay.
Next. The location analysis. Kharghar adjoins the central business district of Belapur in Navi Mumbai and is bound by two major highways and the picturesque of Kharghar Hills. The Taloja Industrial Estate and Taloja Creek are located on the east. Kharghar is coming to be known as the educational capital of Navi Mumbai. There are National Institute of Fashion Technology. There are many engineering colleges also that has opened. Kharghar has a number of ready and under construction projects, both in commercial and residential segments. CIDCO has also built up an 18-hole golf course opposite Central Park in Kharghar, along with shopping malls. So Kharghar has many other infrastructure projects also, like Kharghar railway station lies on Central Railway's Harbour Line, a part of Mumbai suburban railway network. The first phase of Navi Mumbai Metro will be from Belapur to Pendhar via Kharghar. The approximate price range is 1,000 to 15,541 per square feet.
Okay.
And the marketing mix generally includes a 4 P's, that is product, price, place and promotion. Our product is a 2-3 BHK residential apartment, price which is 9,500 per square feet, which is fixed, and it is probably less than the other, compared to the other residential projects in the Kharghar. Place is Kharghar Navi Mumbai, as I said, and it adjoins with the central business district of Belapur, which is again an attractive point to have a residential construction in Kharghar. Promotion, like you can make yourself easy to contact, put your contact info on every page of your website for the for your betterment of the project. Create an irresistible content offer to capture leads. Developing relationship with other local business will be the key for your real estate marketing efforts. Also build up relations with the local brokers, which will bring customers for your project.
Yeah, I just want to add that when you were discussing place, it is more like from where are you going to sell the project. So it could be property shows, it could be through different broker channels, it could be from the site office, not the location. You describe the location. I'm just clarifying that.
Okay. Yeah, sure, sir. And also in promotion, you can set up hoardings in various areas. Now, what is your USP highlight? As Kharghar is a residential township of Navi Mumbai, it adjoins with the central business district. Also, it has many infrastructure projects like commercial projects and industrial also, and it has also built up of 18 golf courses. It is an attractive place for any residential projects. Railway station is also 45 minutes drive away by the road from Kharghar via the Santa Cruz, and these features will facilitate the project in many ways. Also, the market range is less. Less compared to no problem.
Okay.
The market range is 12,000 to 16,000 per square feet for the other residential projects, and our project price range is 9,500, which will play a key role in the in having a successful residential project.
Okay.
So this is the project and market timeline. I have my investment for the land and construct land plus construction is in quarter one it will be 3 crores, in quarter two it will be 2 crores 7 lakhs, in quarter three it will be 7 crores, and quarter four will be 3 crores again.
Supriya, so predicted phase of the, you have not mentioned the year in quarter one. I mean, which year are we talking about? When are you going to start the project?
So actually the project is started, hasn't started yet, but the plot acquisition and all that is started in Feb 2020 only.
Okay, because your projections here of recovery and expansion in quarter three looks very very optimistic, because due to COVID-19 I don't think the markets will come out of recession till 2022 or 2021, I think.
Sir, but as I have read, or maybe it's misunderstanding, but they have told that after COVID-19 also the real estate market will come up with a good.
That's okay. If see, this is an ongoing project, it's fine. But if you are conceptualizing from scratch, the predicted market phases won't hold good. You know, so it's okay. You can also keep the financial and market risk data, because the data at the top is, I mean, it's not matching. It's all right.
Okay. So this is the cash flow projection. NPV and IRR calculation. So my first option was 2 BHK residence, and this is the IIR value yearly for the best case, most likely, and worst case. And my option two was 3 BHK residence, and this is the IRR yearly for best case, most likely, and worst case. So this is the probability analysis. So standard deviation for best case is nearly 17, and most likely is 2.32 worst case. And I have also taken the probability as best case it will be 0.3, most likely will be 0.6, and worst case is 0.1, of course. Well, so I have done the probability.
Ideally, yes, you would add up the variance and then get the standard deviation. Will not have three separate standard deviations for all these three analyses. You can just add these three and then you will get one value, and when you square that, square root it, you will get the standard deviation.
Yes, actually, so I have done that in the Excel sheet, but I thought you have given the three different cases and standard deviation column also. Okay, so I thought the final summary is option one is the 2 BHK and is more feasible than 3 BHK apartment. As we have done the risk analysis, the confidence level at lower end in option two, that is 3 BHK, is negative. So we can assume that option one is less risky than option two. Also, the project location is Kharghar is feasible, as Kharghar is itself a residential township and it is developing also right now. Also, there are many development like colleges, metro rail construction, so which will attract the customers also.
Okay, Supriya, you did very well. I have no other questions.
Okay, thank you, sir.
You can switch off your camera and mute your mic, please.
Yes.
Okay, who's going next?
Sir, I am Nitiksha Vyas.
Give me a moment.